Hi guys. All right, let's go do my final build and test. This is gonna be a series taking me up to, hopefully.
Welcome to the Bee and Barb, my lord. If I can interest you in one of our special drinks, you let me know.
Hopefully, to the completion of being able to do this. Right now, I only have my base 50 mods in.
I'm really getting tired of your excuses. When you borrow them,
and I will be building these group by group.
I know I
can. Starting with
working at the Rift and Fishery is tough.
50 mods, then adding 50 more, and then 25 at a time. Excuse me.
You're a stranger here too, huh? Safe travels.
I don't know you. You can pretend not to hear me all you want, but you better stay out of Blackfriars' business.
My goal is to, as I go through each of these sections, ensure that I have 100% playability with no repeatable crashes, and hopefully no crashes. That everything is functional, playable, fun, and looks good, of course. Mistvale Keep discovered.
The fairest prices and the highest quality in Skyrim.
Thanks for the bushel of apples, Maurice. Oh, wonderful. How did you keep them so fresh?
Gleaming gemstones over here.
Well, whatever you're doing, keep doing it. You'll have me as a customer for life.
Come to see Balaman perform miracles with steel, eh?
Okay, let's go check the docks.
There's an apothecary in town, yeah. It's down on the lower roadway. So stay sharp if you go down.
I do have Dyndaloed loaded. However, currently I do not even have Skyrim Floral Overhaul in, let alone anything else.
What is it?
So no real worries there. I'd actually like to do this, though, as well, to kind of be able to build up a growing comparison as I add on layer and layer and layer to see the differences as I go through them.
Please. Running a little light.
Please,
in the pockets, lad?
No.
I could take a hint, lad. You want to make some coin? Come find me.
How can a humble servant of Talos help you today?
It's hilarious how empty the world looks. And there's through a lot of this I may not actually be talking, being as there's nothing specific that I need to be accomplishing with my talk right now. It doesn't necessarily serve a purpose.
Need something?
Golden Glow Estate. And I have a bit of a cough tonight, apparently. It's like a tickle in the back of my throat. Hello?
Citizen, I'm warning you. Your presence is interfering with...
It's sort of amazing that that's never been fixed, that I know of. But if somebody attacks that group, the prisoner will undo his hands and fight with them, and then not redo his hands, and just... Yeah. His scripting has never been terribly great. Wayfarer increased to 16. Good crap. Let's see, eventually I will be checking inside here, so I'm actually going to go in to make it consistent. Oh dear. Okay. Fur bracers and fur shoes, a cloak, some studded armor. Okay. Okay, let's see. Keep that one. Let's put some heavy armor on. Yeah. Okay, I can make things. So, let's just make an armored circlet. Ice wolf skin cloak, timber wolf skin cloak, resist magic. Magic and there we go. Hello. That's lovely. Okay, let's go here. Giovanna. All right. Hello. So that's 15. There we go. Nice.
Someone there? Over here.
Gold, all right. A scimitar.
Death awaits you.
Ow. In here. That's 13. Code of Malakath. Biography of Baron Zaya, Volume 3. Mysterious Akavir. Galerion the Mystic. Hide helmet, some wine. The Ransom of Zarek. Wisp Mother. Argonian Account, Book 1. And Thief of Virtue. Okay. That's 51. Oh, I'm gonna stay there. 42 gold added. Steel battle axe. Spell tome. Shears. Interesting. The Wolf Queen. Mixed unit tactics. And goat cheese. Bunch of empty bottles. Beef. Okay. Rabbit haunch. Potion of stamina from 2 potions of minor stamina. Warhammer was too much. Ow. Ow, ow, ow. I saw it way too late. Good night. I don't think she actually found me. Found a fate card. Iron greatsword. Okay. Dachi, nice. Ow. Ow. Two hundred 96. Really? Okay, so let's head out of Trevor's Watch. Thank you. so I've got 62 arrows. We've got this one's sort of boring. Solitude to join the Legion. A united empire is better forever. But that is because I am right at the beginning. Hello?
I'm on a pilgrimage to the Shrine of Azura, the goddess of twilight, if you'll excuse me.
Stendar's mercy be upon you, for the vigil has none to spare.
Eventually I will get to the place where I will actually... you know, maybe I won't walk. Not for the tests. It doesn't really gain me anything. I would walk if I was using the Running Drain's stamina, but... I've decided that even on the lowest, that one combined with like Percus Maximus and such is really difficult. I would really need to put, like, no matter what character I play, I'd need to put a lot into stamina to be able to make that one valid, and I don't necessarily want to do that. I'd like it if stamina went up for other reasons, like if you just gained a couple stamina points every level. I think that'd be cool. Personally, I've always felt that every time you level, you should get, like...
Please help. I can pay you.
You okay?
Bandits attacked and ransacked my cart. Can you help me?
What can I do?
My camp is nearby in the ruins of Nilheim. Get me there safely, and you'll be rewarded.
I've always felt that, especially on a difficult game, every time you level, you should get, like, 15 points of your main thing, you know, if you choose health, and then, like, 7 points of a secondary one, and 3 points of the third one, so that all of them are always going up.
Never should have come here.
Dude, he jumped right off there. That was nice. Alright, 297. Because that way, as you're leveling up, even when you're not focusing on, say, your stamina. Let's say you just want to do health and magicka. Over time, your stamina still gets a little bit better. Nope, still more. Okay, there we go. You know, maybe I'll do some research looking at the uncapper to see if there is a way to actually make that happen as I level up. I totally missed. Totally missed again. Because that'd be nice. I also think that in doing so, let's get rid of that. Yep. In doing so, it would actually make it so, because my game, when it's fully loaded, gets really, really difficult, and I want to play it on probably at least, adept, but to do so, I kind of feel like I need to add a little bit more perks, and I need to add higher amounts, you know, when I get when I take health, I want to add more than just say 10. But I think if I did that, so it was 15, 7, and 3. There's no way to really select three of them, though, is there? I wonder if there's a way to manually change that number. Because the perks, I was considering doing two per level, because especially with Percus Maximus, there's a ton of perks to take, and with it being so difficult, it would make it so I end up with a little bit better ability to have survivability. What I'm going to do with that is I'm actually going to lower that so it's not two per level. It'll be just above one per level. Drat. But I will also be using, hopefully, Dragon Soul Relinquishment, if I can get it actually in. I might not be able to, but we'll see. So that the more Dragon Souls I get, I can actually trade in, like, 5 Dragon Souls and get a perk. So that's nice. And the other one I'll be using is Sky Shards, the Elder Scrolls Online one. And that'll be nice, because between those two, it'll actually give me more perks over time that I can accumulate via exploration. And via fighting dragons, which should be pretty dang difficult. And I like that. Hello.
I've been hunting and fishing in these parts for years.
And the end of this first video, we'll be back at Riften. And the second video will go to Dawnguard, probably to the border, and probably actually to Shorestone, let's say. And my current mod count, again, is 50 right now. Not very many. Man, those forests look nightmarish. The total time that it took me, as a matter of fact, was to generate all of this, was about 20 minutes. I think it was 20, 25 minutes, right in there. So, not too bad. I will try to keep track of everything that I have, and currently there are no errors in TES5 edit or in loot, nor are there any out-of-order masters in Rybash. So, yeah. Excuse me. Oh, I have two levels. Nice. Bound dagger added. Sparks. And bound dagger creates a magic dagger for 120 seconds. Okay, cool. Damage 11. Magicka. Let's do illusion. Okay. my total mod list when I get up towards the top of it, which is where I'm trying to weed out just the last few minor conflicts and potential crashes, was topping 400 or so. So we'll see how it does.
Give them the dogs, boys.
Heartwood Mill discovered. Something in here, and I do not know what it was, but it sent out two huge Dwemer, whatever they were, the Goliaths or whatever they are, when I was playing this afternoon. It was ridiculous. Avanchnazel. Those Dwemer words. Tell you what. Three arrows. Excuse me. The basic mods that I have in right now, would be Winter is Coming and Cloaks of Skyrim, plus Nerevar's and the Cloaks of Skyrim Yusleep patch, Bandoliers and Bandoliers Dawnguard, with improved Bandoliers, Jesus, Heavy Armory, Immersive Armor and Immersive Weapons, Percus Maximus, get off me, Live Another Life, heard something. Papyrus Utility with Sky UI and Race Menu Plus. Safety Load and Autosave and Crash Fixes. Yusleep, obviously. Dawnguard Arsenal and Improved Close-Faced Helms with WFAR, CCF, CRF and CCOR all included, plus XP32 for the skeleton, the realistic ragdoll and force, I do have the Vividian ENB and Vivid Weathers installed with SMIM and Legacy of the Dragonborn, plus, of course, patches for everything that I need. Less HUD, more HUD, and iHUD. The Vanilla Trees, the Enhanced Vanilla Trees, and Dying to Load. FNIS, Purity, and its Billboards. SKSE F4, Uncapper, and the Skyrim Enhanced Camera. And ELE Light, ELFX, and some to handle Percus Maximus. So that is a total of 50 mods currently. And we had zero errors. We are back here. And I will save here, pick up in the next video. Thanks for watching. And let's see you next time.